Hi, Anthony here again. Thanks for joining me in this discussion about difficult bosses in medicine, where we try and highlight the issues around what makes the difference between a good boss in medicine versus a not so good boss, and even a frankly bad one. Really hoping to improve the level of management in medicine because I really think it does contribute to some of the real problems we see these days. Grateful for all the feedback so far, and if you care to share your stories, you can do so with me in the comments section below, or you can contact me through the course that's linked to this channel. So I just came back from the On the Wards conference and had the chance to present on this topic about difficult bosses in medicine. I was really happy with the feedback that I got. Lots of great comments and support for the idea. One of the questions from the audience at that conference was about this concept of how does one tell when someone is in the boss role in medicine? And I thought it was a really good one. So I'm entitling this talk today, Who's the Boss?
There is more to life than what you're living. So take a chance and face the wind. An open road and a road that's hit. A brand new life around the bend. There were times.
So 80 sitcoms set aside, there are plenty of situations in medicine where the situation of who is the boss can be flipped somewhat. You can have more junior people in charge of more senior people. You can have other disciplines in charge of other disciplines. The scenario this trainee delegate at the On the Wards conference gave me was the situation when you're covering the wards of an evening and you're in charge of a number of wards and you have nursing staff, some of whom you may never have met, calling you up for help. And the question was, well, am I a boss in that situation? And I think the answer is yes. To some extent, you are managing other people, you're helping them with their work, you're in charge. And it led us to a very healthy discussion about some of the things that you can do early on as a trainee in medicine to develop good habits in terms of being a boss. For example, do you thank the nursing staff when they call you with a request to see the patient? Or do you see that as a bit of an imposition on your time, and do you come across as a little bit rude and annoyed? That sort of difference in message can make a powerful difference in terms of how the person you're working with feels about you. And let's be frank and honest about it, can sometimes come back to bite you. So if you're known as one of those trainees as a bit rude and gruff after hours, less responsive, less thankful, that reputation is going to end up preceding you, and it's probably going to make your life a bit more difficult, at least as long as you're a trainee. So we can practice the habit of thanking people and giving them some positive praise on their efforts. There's this important rule in management, which is called the rule of fives. So the rule goes like this: for every one negative comment you receive, you really need five positive comments, so that you don't feel drowned and depressed by the feedback that you receive. And let's think about it. How often are we just told that we thank you for doing our job in medicine? How often are we given positive feedback from those that we work with? Probably not as often as we really require. So let's practice early on some good boss behavior and remember the rule of fives. Think about thanking people a bit more often that you work with, whether that be peers, even your supervisors, or those below you in the team. If you're a resident, maybe you've got some interns that work with you, or medical students. If you're a registrar, you'll have plenty of time to thank your residents and interns for their efforts. If they've done something well, let them know. Don't just wait till there's a stuff up and then point that out to someone. People need to know that they've done things well, and gives them the confidence to keep going and learning. In the first video, I talked about some of my thoughts as to why we do have a problem with management in medicine, and I think there are many. And today I just wanted to highlight another reason that I think helps to understand why there is this problem in getting good boss behavior in medicine. It's this concept in management theory called the Peter Principle, which you may have heard of before. Theory is, it makes a lot of sense when you think about it. Essentially, the way the theory goes is that people are promoted within organisations based on their past performance. So if they do a good job at what they're currently doing, they get to go up in the pecking order. And think about that, probably works quite well, particularly if you're just progressing along a career path in a certain area. For example, if you're a doctor and you're just getting promoted, so seeing more and more patients, more difficult patients, that will probably work. But it doesn't work when you're being promoted into another area which needs a different skill set. And so we often see this, that people are promoted within their profession and then a management job comes up and someone's promoted into that and all of a sudden their performance drops off. And the reason is that they're promoted on their past behaviour and their past performance, which is completely unrelated to the roles and skills needed in the new job. And sadly, no one has bothered to look at that and prepare the person for those sort of managerial skills, give them some training, give them some budding before they're asked to do that role. Another way of thinking of it is we tend to try the same solutions on similar problems, even as they get more challenging. But eventually that sort of solution will not work, but we'll keep trying it. Well, that's the same problem. So now the Peter Principle is, again, like most things, not restricted to medicine or health in particular. In fact, within health, we often see other professions promoted to managerial roles without being properly prepared for that. But it helps to go a long way to explain why we have this problem. And look, in future videos, I hope to talk about some of the solutions in training programs to better prepare everyone, I think, in medicine for that sort of managerial role. So finally, just getting back to the On the Boards conference, another question I was asked about was, how does one go about getting feedback on their management style? And I think this is something that can be a real good tip for people who are wanting to improve themselves as a medical boss. Look, there are a number of ways, and a really good tool that I would certainly recommend to people is investing in what's called a 360 degree performance review. But as a step before that, in terms of wanting to get genuine feedback from your trainees, there's a little tip and technique that I can highly recommend. There's this concept called rounding, and it goes a little bit like this. You need to set yourself up and be open as a manager for some feedback on your performance. So think about the five or six things that you as a manager could or should be doing better for your trainee, and then write them down. And then think about how you would ask those sort of questions of the trainee. So an example would be, are you available enough if the trainee is concerned? Another example would be, does the trainee have enough support from you if there's something they need to do their job better? So write those questions down and keep them as a list so that you've got them in front of you when you can make an opportunity to meet with the trainee. Make sure it's done in a private setting, a comfortable setting, and the trainee is kind of pre-warned that it's a meeting to talk about how things are going. Now, you'll find the first time that you engage in this sort of discussion, it may be taken as a bit of a shock for the trainee, because it's probably the first time anyone above them's ever asked them there, directly at least, for some feedback on their performance. So don't be shocked if the first time you sit down with a trainee and go through your list that you're just told, look, everything's okay, that's good, I'm glad you asked, everything's hunky-dory. It's probably going to take two, and more realistically, three times sitting down with the trainee, establishing that trusting relationship, going through the list, really asking them, really saying, look, I'm open to feedback, I really want to know, is there anything I can do to help you, before they're going to feel safe and feel like that you're genuine in giving you some feedback. And look, often it's little things, it's not dramatic. It might be as simple as suggestions for changing your routine a little bit in terms of how you might conduct a board round, for example. But those sort of things can make a real difference for the trainee, and really establish yourself as a listening manager and someone who has genuine concern for the trainee. So give it a go. It's called rounding, and it's a useful thing that I've used in my work. So look, that's the finish of the video today. Been collecting some good stories, some cases of difficult bosses in medicine. We'd love to get some more, so please, as I said, put some in the comments or go to the website and leave us some stories. Please encourage other people to view the videos and subscribe, and I hope to join you again soon.